What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another exciting episode on the channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at a very specific swim bait that I kind of just got in recently, and I'm going out and fishing with it, and I think it's actually a really badass little swim bait. So we're going to be taking a look at it today. So if you guys are ready, let's get right into today's video. So a lot of you guys know on this channel that I like to fish, you know, bigger swim baits. We're talking anything over 6 inches for the most part. That's pretty much my go-to when it comes down to fishing swim baits. You know, the smallest bait that I normally fish is like the tiny clash, and that's like 6.5 inches, anywhere all the way up to like the mother and the mother chaser. So we don't really fish these smaller swim baits on this channel. The only other one that I've ever really actually fished on this channel is the baby bull shad. And I actually really ended up liking that swim bait more than I would have thought. I caught a lot of fish down here at just these local urban spots, and it was a really fun time fishing that bait around. And so the swim bait that I have today is kind of on the same similar spectrum as that baby bull shooter. It's small, it's segmented, and it's kind of new. We're taking a look at the Ayumu S-Squad 120. Now, this little guy came to me probably like a couple weeks ago, and I've been trying to get out and fish with it and see exactly what it does. And I'm fairly impressed with the swim on this bait. Overall, I actually really like this bait. I think it's a dope little swim bait. It's only 120 millimeters, weighs 1 ounce, and it's a floating swim bait. Now, if you guys could maybe tell, but this head design actually comes from Roman Made from their Murai, which is one of their glide baits that they've made. A lot of people don't really know about the Murai, but it's a cool looking swim bait. It's got like this really fat front section, and they kind of thins out near the tail section. So they pretty much took the head from that. And when I mean they, I mean Ayumu. This company actually collabed with Roman Made, so that's why this bait kind of looks like that. But instead of a glide, it's a multi-segmented bait with two joints in it. And so I've been fishing around with this swim bait for like the past few days, just getting out, fishing it, trying it in, you know, different weights on it with a snap, no snap. And this is pretty much how I run it right now, which I have just a small little decoy egg snap in the front. I believe it's like a size 3. Out of the package, it's a floating swim bait. So it just sits high up on the water, and it's got a nice S motion to it. And when I first got it, I fished it that way. I even caught a fish on it doing it that way.
Nice. Oh, yeah. That was cool. That was sweet.
And so I caught that fish just like waking it right on top of the surface. That fish came up and swirled it and ate it. So I like it when it's kind of low light conditions or there's a bunch of long shadows, and I can wake it up on top of the water. But I felt like when the sun kind of came up, I wanted something that where it would at least suspend when I casted it out there. Because on a retrieve, when you cast it out there fairly far, you can actually get it to kind of go right below the surface for a little bit if you slow down your retrieve. If you speed it up, it's going to stay right on top of the water. But if you slow it down, even when it's just right out of the package, it'll go down just a little bit, but it'll still create that waking motion. So what I actually ended up doing with this specific bait, I put a small piece of weight down there on the bottom. And so what that weight did is when I would make it a long cast, when it hit the water, it would go down and it would kind of sit there and suspend. And then with that fluorocarbon that I fished with it, it would kind of get it to be a super slow sinking. But then when I started the retrieve, it would come back up to the surface, but this time it would stay right below the surface, maybe like 2 inches below the surface. So if I wanted to get it to wake, I would just have to fish it a little bit faster. So me adding that weight on there just allowed me to cover water a little bit faster and have that bait stay a little further down in the water. The specific weight that I use is just the Zapu, the board weight. I have these just in the 2 gram because I like to put these sometimes on like my Clash 9s or my Tiny Clashes. So what I did is with the 2 gram, is the only size that I had, is I actually just cut it in half. And so it pretty much went down to a 1 gram. And with that 1 gram, it got the bait to kind of just suspend there. So out of the box, the hardware that comes with the bait is actually not that bad. I believe these split rings that are on there are actually owners. They're really strong. They're way stronger than I thought, especially for split rings of this size. The hooks that come with it are Gamagatsu, which I honestly didn't expect. A lot of swimbait brands and just brands in general out in Japan, they've been using Ryugis lately. So I thought these at first were Ryugis, but they're actually Gamagatsu. And I was kind of skeptical at first with it, but with the fish that I hooked, I didn't bend any of the hooks out when I flipped them. The hooks didn't bend out or anything like that. Obviously, I'm not hooking, you know, 5 to 8 pounders on this bait, but if you were in an area that you know you could probably hook a big one and, you know, you're fishing tight to cover, I would probably upgrade these hooks to something maybe a little bit stronger, but you have to kind of keep that same size. But it is really hard to get hooks, any type of hooks, this size, and they're really, really strong. It's really, really hard. So you definitely have to kind of play them. You can't horse them in that much, especially if you hook a bigger fish. But I was very surprised by the Gamagatsus on this bait that they actually worked really, really well. So again, out of package, it didn't come with the split ring. I fished it, but I felt like I could get more action out of it if I added a snap to the front. So I added this size 3 decoy egg snap to the front. You could definitely even go down to a smaller, like size 2, and you'll do just fine. The smallest that I had was a size 3. Fished with it, and it worked just fine. I felt like I was getting great action out of it overall with that snap up there in the front. So that's kind of the general overall of, you know, what you get out of the box. Now, there is one thing to kind of note with this bait is here on this front joint, there's actually like a little groove indent where when the bait goes side to side and it's swimming, it has like a little spot to kind of dig into. And I kind of like that. You get just a little bit wider of this action, and it's got a killer swim to it. This S motion that is out of this bait looks great. You can also twitch it. The twitches look really erratic. Sometimes you can kind of control which direction it'll go when you twitch it. But sometimes if I'm fishing tight to like a piece of cover and I'll start twitching it, it'll actually twitch out away from the cover. So you kind of have to get a luck of the draw when you twitch it. There's not a whole lot of control on this bait just because it is a segmented bait. So you kind of have to get lucky on where the bait actually starts twitching. But if you twitch it and it goes in the direction that you want, it actually goes kind of like this to the side. And I think that's really badass, so you can kind of get it up under things that way as well. Now, the durability of this bait so far, there's really no paint chips at all. I've definitely hit some rocks. I've definitely hit the bank a couple times, just straight cement. And so far, it still holds up pretty good. There is, of course, a little bit of hook rash just because that's just how it is. But overall, this little thing has been pretty good so far for me. Now, the setup that I've been fishing with this bait, since it's such a small bait, I don't really have a dedicated swimbait rod for this. And I think that's kind of just fine because what's so cool is about when you get into, you know, smaller swimbaits like this bait or like the baby bullshad, you don't really have to go out and buy a dedicated swimbait setup to throw a bait like that. I mean, I've been fishing it on just this old classic Veritas rod. It's a 7'3". It's a medium heavy action rod. It loads fairly well. It's kind of like a soft jig rod or spinnerbait rod. It's rated up to 1 ounce. It fishes it just well. And that's pretty much all you need. Like a 7' medium heavy or 7'3" medium heavy, and you'll do just fine. but you just need a rod that one can cast it, and two, since this bait has, you know, such small hooks that when a fish comes up and bites it, if your rod is too stiff and there is like no absorption of that bite, what'll happen is since these hooks are so small, they'll just fly out of the fish's mouth and you'll miss them. So when you're fishing with a bait with trebles like this small, you want something to load. It's kind of like the same thing with like a jerkbait rod. You have those smaller treble hooks, but your rod loads on that initial bite. And it's kind of the same thing as like a crankbait as well. You can even use a crankbait rod or a jerkbait rod, but you know, obviously a jerkbait, a crankbait rod meant for some of those bigger crankbaits and jerkbaits to fish a bait like this, and you'll do great with a rod like that as well. But too stiff of a rod, like if you have too stiff of a jig rod or too stiff of like a flipping stick, you might miss some bites just because it doesn't allow those fish to really get that bait in their mouths properly and the hooks to kind of reposition and actually hook them. So that's kind of one thing to think about. The reel that I use is just an old school Daiwa Tatula 150.
The heck is this thing?
Just a Daiwa Tatula 100, literally just a normal bass setup that I would use for jigs or spinnerbaits or crankbaits or whatever, anything like that. It's what I'm fishing with when it comes down to swimbaits in that 1 ounce size range. It's a 7:3:1 gear ratio reel. You could definitely go down to a slower gear, like a 6:3:1. I just obviously always like to fish with the higher gear ratio reel. But like I said, sometimes I like to cover a lot of water, so I'm able to burn bank with this thing. But there are some times where I definitely feel like I'm fishing way too fast just because, you know, I like to burn a lot for the most part. But there are some times where having that slower gear ratio reel might help me keep that bait a little bit further down in the water column. But when you fish it too fast, it wants to rise up and come up to the surface. But again, adding that weight has allowed me to fish it the way that I like to fish it, which is burn it quick with this fast gear ratio reel. It's able to stay down there and you're good to go. But if you're going to fish it without like adding any extra weight to it, I would recommend you going with kind of a slower gear ratio reel, like a 6:4:1. And then when it comes down the line, I am fishing it right now on 20-pound FC Sniper fluorocarbon. So I know 20 pounds is definitely overkill for a bait of that size. It's just what I have. The next size down that I have is like 8-pound fluorocarbon for my spinning setup. But if you literally don't want to go too deeply into it, just use what you've got. I mean, it fishes just fine on that 20-pound fluorocarbon. It is a bit thinner than most other lines. Obviously, I'm not fishing it on like 20-pound mono or copoly. That'd just be way too thick and it wouldn't work out. The 20-pound fluorocarbon, since it is a little bit heavier, it gets the bait down there and kind of stays down there a little bit easier. But you can, I would definitely recommend you fish it on like anything from 14 to like 16, 17-pound fluorocarbon. And I think you can really get this bait to fish and shine really well. But if you just have 20-pound fluorocarbon, it'll do just fine on that. But definitely think you can get most out of this bait if you fish it on that 14 to 17-pound fluorocarbon. So yeah, that's the Ayumu S-Squad. It's a dope little bait. And I'm really glad that I was able to actually get one, fish it, and see what's up with it. Even though, again, it is a very small bait, I don't know if I'd see myself actually going out to some of these, you know, big bodies of water and fishing it. I could definitely see certain times when they're feeding on like smaller bluegill that this bait could absolutely shine and wreck them. But for right now, I'm just, you know, going down to my local urban spots where these fish would absolutely munch a bait of this size. I mean, here's a couple other fish catches that I've got on this bait recently.
Got him. Oh god. Ugh, it's a nice one. Oh fuck. Oh fuck. Get in the boat. Yeah, dude. That was sweet. Okay. completely fucking missed it, dude. That was sick. That was so sick. It's a nice one, too. Oh, it's a giant. Holy shit. Dude, did you see that? Holy crap. That was so sick. Oh, that's a nice one. In the face, baby. Oh my goodness.
It's a big one. So yeah, this is kind of just like the overview of this bait. Once I fish it a little bit more and really start putting it to the test on maybe some bigger fish, I'll let you guys know if it's really worth picking up. Right now, I'm not exactly sure where you can even get one of these. If I find a place, I'll leave a link down in the description below if you guys wanted to check it out. Really dope bait. Absolutely sick. Like it. It's a great size. It's got a great swim to it. For those guys that fish ponds and they're really big into eating bluegill, this might be a bait that would be really cool to fish at them. And before we end this video, I have been getting a lot of questions about what glasses that I use when I come down to fishing. And these are just Big Fish 1983s. They make some pretty cool glasses. I remember when I first saw these, they were on Instagram. And the thing that hooked me the most was they have this little bass design on the side of the glasses. And I think that was super cool. So I was like, yo, like these are really rad. So they sent me a few pairs to test out and try, and I really like them. They're lightweight. They're made out of just, you know, your regular plastic, but they're on the cheaper side of things. They're only like $50 or so, and they're stylish. They're cool. They're lightweight. They're a super awesome company. They're actually from Paris, France. So if you guys are into your high-end fashion, you get to say that you have something from Paris that doesn't cost you thousands of dollars. But Big Fish 1983, they're awesome glasses. I will leave a link to their Instagram and their website down below if you guys also wanted to check out the glasses. Other than that, thank you guys so much for watching. And one more big announcement. Myself and my buddy Phoenix, we're going to be going out to Austin, Texas here in less than a month now. And we're going to hopefully see if we can catch some fish out there and make some awesome video for you guys. We're going to try and link up with some homies out there. And pretty much the whole goal is just to go out there, have some fun fishing big swim baits, and try and get, you know, a giant bass out in Texas, because they've been pumping them out lately and we're just trying to get ourselves one as well. So be on the lookout, hopefully, for those videos. We're going to be out there in like mid to late April-ish. If you guys want to stay along with the journey, follow me on Instagram. I'll leave a link to that also down in the description below. Other than that, thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, go out there and chase your dreams.